Welcome back, everybody, here to your ESWC qualifiers. This is the semi-final, game number three we get to get pushed to. After over a one-hour marathon in game number one, we go into game number two, where it's quick and dirty. And now we go into game number three, where the world is possibly the oyster that needs to be shelled and then had a pearl pulled out of it to give us this game. Let's jump ourselves inside the draft, and I can introduce you my pearl of the broadcast. He is the captain of Pulse. And he is possibly one of the most sexiest men in Sweden, and is definitely one of the men that can definitely handle himself after a little bit of liquor. It is Wagamama. It is Wagamama. How you doing, man? How you doing?
I'm good. Better than in Kiev.
you were great in Kiev. It was when you were leaving it that you were having issues.
Yeah, I was about to stay in Kiev, but I don't know. It turned out okay anyway.
As long as everything works out in the end, that's what it's all about. You gotta love this again. Templar Assassin gets through the pool. Dendi maybe has to play it again, or maybe Havorst.
This time, though, there is no Batrider.
It's true, Batrider gets banned out, but Bucky Mag gets his Enigma. And that makes up for everything. This guy is amazing on Enigma.
Yeah?
Yep.
I haven't seen him play too much recently, so...
Well not recently, because he hasn't been in a team of recent. Shiba Gaming or Shakira or old MTW, they basically haven't played since International 2.
Yeah.
Apart from the qualifier that happened 2 days ago. That was basically it. There was no more after that. But we get Chandler Shrek as well as TA again from Puppy. So, very predictable for the way we're going to be running our lanes right now. But Shakira and Enigma both were banned out in the last game. And Bucky Mouse managed to grab both of them in this. And a Cottle as well. Funnily enough, also banned in the last game. You can only pick what's banned.
Yeah, it's the new rule. The rule of the picks.
When we get the big bans out, no Tinker in this game. No stalling their push, no Void to have a too overpowered team fight.
Well, it's funny to see that Lanaya actually lost, or Templar Assassin actually lost both the games. So let's see if she can break her losing spree here. And let's see if Na'Vi are going to give away first blood again.
Yeah, that's a good point. Good point. We're going to keep our eyes open for that.
Yeah.
Also got to see if I'm going to miss first blood as well. Haven't done it yet today.
Nice.
Screwed up other things, but we haven't missed first blood, and that's the most important thing in the world of Dota.
The first one, at least.
Mm-hmm. One of the first.
So first blood is so important. Like, in my team, I'm playing offlane nowadays, always, and it's such a big thing to give away first blood. It's something many players don't really care too much about. It obviously Light of Heaven, Bamboo, some other players, but they do stand to gain that they are aggressive, that they can get more experience, you know, and they can try to force the attention of the supporters to their lane. But other than that, I feel giving away first place is really, really bad. In all scenarios, you should rather be more careful. And I have a very different playstyle from Babu, but we were talking about it at Star Ladder. He's just greedy. That's what it comes down to in his mind.
He wants farm. It's great if it pays off, though. It's absolutely amazing if it pays off. But if it doesn't, then your team gets completely and utterly destroyed.
It's risky. No, not really that you get utterly destroyed, but you
change the balance,
like,
of power.
In game one, I was already calling out that the trialing of the Dire team in game one was so much stronger, but then one of them gets caught out before creep spawn and dies first blood, and that sets the tone of the entire trialing, how it progresses. And people can go, oh, but it doesn't make too big impact. They didn't have any of those items in the first phase in the laning anyway, but it kind of does. And when you die first blood that early, it also typically makes you a bit more passive on your lane, and you never want to be passive when you have undying. And that entire game was pretty much role model for passive. Yeah. But this is a new game, and I'm pretty happy to see Tiny.
Yeah, man, it's It's great to see him up in the pool again. We saw him earlier today being played by Dignitas, and there was devastating once the tree gets in his hand, and it's not going to work out too nicely for Chaos Knight with all his phantasms during those team fights.
Thinking about that as well, as well as the Gen Creeps thing disappear.
But my thing I'm thinking about, though, is landing. Like, Na'Vi is so bloody obvious, it's not funny. Latrak, CK, Chen, down their safe lane, TA in the middle lane, and Windrunner up in towards that top lane. Light of Heaven will be taking up his role. But as far as Shiba Gaming goes, what are we looking at here? Like, are we going to see an aggressive lane down that bottom? We know Sock, he's on Tiny, bucking Mad Enigma. That's pretty obvious to go with as well. Or do we run it safe and throw Coddle on the offlane?
I think it's going to be safe play, but I'm not sure if it's going to be Coddle offlane. They could even
It's going to be aggressive. It's going to be aggressive because Funzie's on Storm Spirit, which means we're looking at Funzie to go solo top, which means Jakiro, Coddle. Jakiro. What the hell? Actually, what is Jakiro fitting into this?
Yeah, I think it's going to be Enigma solo lane because there are two support heroes beside Enigma. And that typically renders you that one of his support side is solos or Enigma. So obviously Coddle could solo.
Calculus will actually solo, man. It's Jakiro. So Calc will probably run in towards that middle lane, throw him up against the TA.
Probably, yeah. Enigma is jungling build anyway, so yep, you're right.
Oh, so we need to to remake.
I took states.
States, yeah, it's called a status, but we need a remake anyway, so for people who don't understand what we're trolling about, he took stats.
States
is like states
plus two states.
I took states. Now there's less flags on the stars on the American flag.
How many levels did the US skill in states if they get plus two every time, Toby?
I don't know. Is it 57?
I don't even know.
how many states are there in America? How many stars are there on the flag?
I never counted them, you know.
Well, I remember there's the correlation between how many states are 50 stars. Okay, well I at least got in the right kind of like ballpark of this sort.
So. 21 levels in states.
Oh, well done. We managed to host the game up in captain's mode, which is not obviously helpful at all. So everyone back in the game again. Everybody back in the new game. And we get broadcaster slot number one.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's right. We
get own Matrix.
Sure. All right, so instant launch. We're into the game again, and we can enjoy ourselves some fun Dota. Some fun Dota is what we're looking for. Some great Dota as well. It is one of these fun moments when you go, you know what? All I really hope for is a great game of Dota. Give me a great game of Dota. That's what I want, man. Like the epicness level of Dota that could only be expressed in 100 kills in an evenly sided match that lasts for 30 minutes with towers going down, triple raxing being done, you hit back for two racks, then the throne rush, then mega creeps, and yeah.
It's not going to happen. It's going to be a short and quick game. Easy, easy, easy.
Maybe. So the difference in this game, man, the difference in this game is that I see counter push ability. Coddle and Jakiro. There is no way in hell, even if you want to throw an avalanche and toss into this combo, there's no way in hell that Na'Vi can force like they did last game. They forced so much in the last game, they got so much advantage that you can't do that against this lineup.
It's very, very different.
Mm-hmm.
Both teams work differently from the previous lineups. Na'Vi aren't really looking to all in that much either, because last game they had DK and stuff, now they have CK. So the difference is that their late game with Lanaya as well as CK is pretty strong. Of course, Tiny is a total beast late game.
Yeah.
We've seen that before.
I've seen it many, many times from Black. He loves playing that one late. As well as a lot of American teams. They always love running their Tiny. We're going to see a full 5v5 initiation. So running through who's playing what will be put on hold for the moment to see if Dendi will die first or will be Light of Heaven. Well, will there be any of these kind of guys? We got a lot of damage very early
on.
Don't
think anyone will die. Everyone will just run out.
Yeah. Navi just wanted to plant one ward, so we can do our introductions, man. So be Light of Heaven on the top lane. He'll be taking up the role as the Windrunner. Heading down south will be Havorst, playing as the Chaos Knight. He'll be supported by Ars, Art, and Puppy, moving through the jungle and going everywhere, always supporting the bottom lane, but always making sure Dendi in the middle lane as a Templar Assassin will always have some company. And towards our middle lane, it will be Funzi going solo mid as the Storm Spirit. Down towards the bottom lane is currently Ryze heading down there. Bucking Mad prep for the to deward the jungle. He won't need to do it in the end, and he'll get to jungle pretty uncontested. Calculus is the Jakiro up on the top lane supporting Sock. So that is our lineup. So it will be an offlane Cottle.
Sock. I always think about Barney Stinson when I hear that. I don't know. But...
I still love the fact that you have a like suit pajamas. I always kind of like imagined having suit pajamas. How awesome would that be?
That would be too much awesome.
If anyone's coming to Kiev in December for Starladder, and you know where you can buy suit pajamas, let me know. Light of Heaven, top lane. Avalanche will hit as well. He's gonna run out of time for this wind run, but the evasion's enough.
Calculus would need to position himself to go around. But lanes weren't actually, as we predicted, a bit different. Mm. And Storm is the one to face Lanaya then.
I'm not liking his chances in here, especially when Puppy does this. Troll Trap is there. Dendi's in close, but then again, that Static Remnant does a lot of damage. And Dendi almost going to go down the creep. And Puppy will stand its ground to finish the job. But Dendi, that is
Funzi.
One lucky TA.
I think Dendi should have died there. He just didn't hit him the second time.
he probably didn't realize that was that could have been such a good thing.
Yeah, all those creeps hitting Lanaya at the same time because Dendi was running in very over aggressively there.
Mm-hmm. I actually thought that range creep was going to get the first blood. It'll be like, hey, MVP, ranged die creep.
Ranged creep. As in any game where Drow Ranger is playing. MVP, every ranged unit
of course. Drow Ranger is always the most valuable player on the map. Even before she got buffed, she was always the most valuable player on the map. Shut up! She did not! Unless it was called for.
Yeah. No, she pretty bad. But now, most Imba hero pretty much after Centaur, of course.
Mm. And again, we haven't seen her picked up yet, man.
So much. No, but you can't pick her. That's why.
What?
No, you can't pick her.
Wait, no, she's in the captain's mode, isn't she?
Well,
she didn't get pulled out of it.
Not unless they added her. They removed her when they changed everything. They removed her from captain. Because she is Imba. Same with Centaur. And Silencer, I think, too. Silencer might be in the pool. I'm not sure.
Silencer's in there, I'm pretty sure, man. I love Ryze's way of defending. Hide around the corner, stay away as long as possible, and now Puppy, most valuable player. Second kill for him.
Yeah, Storm is not strong against Lanaya. Like, he can handle his own, but he's also such an easy hero to gank before level 6. And that is very dangerous, because it gives a huge momentum to Lanaya.
I love Chen's build as well. Doing it because he doesn't have to sacrifice until he gets level 5. He can't get the double creep anyway. We're putting the second point into Test of Faith.
Mm.
Obviously, with the rework that happened to Chen.
It's so expensive to send someone home, though. You don't really want to do it in the early game.
Mm-hmm. Like you lose your entire mana pool. He can't do it now.
It's 200 mana. It's insane.
Looks like we're going to get ourselves a bit of a gank. Remember Bucking Mad's Enigma. Never forget Bucking Mad's Enigma. He's going to come towards the top lane, got 2 points up at the Malifus.
Yeah, this is very dangerous. All these creeps coming in. Light of Heaven should feel that something is going to happen when all these creeps come.
Yep, he's already moving back.
Very careful.
So this is the reason why Light of Heaven is professional player.
He probably saw him, though, with his ward. I don't think he smoked or anything.
No, he didn't smoke to come in, but he wouldn't have seen him because he rotated around. So there's only a dire ward that's watch. Oh no, you're right. There's a radiant ward right on top of that little
wards.
Red dot.
That's a lot to rotate around. Mm. But it's gonna be a tower trade. Both teams getting a tower.
Yeah, bottom tier one tower goes down, and top tier one tower will take a fall.
Yep.
And all in the meantime, Denny just keeps on farming while Storm Spirit finds a haste room with no bottle, which doesn't really help him. Denny's just getting that tortoise to run over time.
Failed toss by Sox on the tower, trying to last it, but missing with toss. Worth noting.
It's pretty hard to miss with toss, actually.
Yeah, it is. That's why it's noteworthy. And CK going in for Lash or Coddle.
Yeah, 2 seconds done, and Chen's creep right in the high ground. Again, Puppy. Third kill, not going to happen. The Force needs a little bit more. The damage might be enough. Coddle Blast! Rise
Gaming.
Killing the over-committing Havorst.
Yeah, and he got experience for the Centaur as well, so that's a lot of EXP coming his way all of a sudden.
2.5 out of nothing. And there's your toss kill on the tower from Tiny.
Yeah, so he does pick it up this time.
In fact, Denny's made a pair of boobs in the middle lane, waiting for the return of Storm Spirit.
Yeah.
And Line of Heaven back towards that top lane, but Tiny level 5.5 already. He's got some decent cash. Well, his gold per minute must be pretty decent. Actually,
yeah,
it's not.
Very low mana though, so Line of Heaven takes advantage and just hits him.
His gold per minute is actually quite low. Like, we're looking at 357 for him. Chen's got more gold per minute because he got first blood, but he's got more gold per minute. And then CK and TA take the cake. 444 now up for Dendi in the middle lane.
That's because they don't fail last hits.
That's also because Storm's been rotating around. He's been looking for runes. He's been semi going down to maybe help with a different lane. He has been in that middle lane long enough.
By the ganks.
That's also because Denny's got 22 denies for that middle lane.
It's pretty wonderful lane to lane Lanaya against a hero like Storm.
It's kind of weird that he did it. Like, you'd think, like, as far as Shiba Gaming's choice.
I don't know. They don't have any amazing hero.
First low. Funzi. Trouble. Latrak hits the stun. That's going to be the death of him. Denny with a kill. The Ice Path comes a little bit late. Light of Heaven. A little bit of trouble here with Sox. Now he's going to dive back to pass the tower. It's a force all over again. Power shot this time, but the tower gets the kill. Getting killed by the Radiant.
Yeah. Well, a lot of overcommitment by the carry heroes. Blink Dagger is now finished on Lanaya, 6:45 in-game.
Mm-hmm.
So he will start killing Coddle and heroes like that pretty easily.
Well, Coddle and Jakira, they're basically food for a Templar Assassin.
I think he's going to go out of control in this game. It just feels like it. He had a good lane, good ganks by Puppy, and now with super early Blink Dagger against a team that doesn't really have that good heroes against him. I feel Lanaya should really dominate this game.
Well, should do, but we'll have to wait and see. I'm still waiting to see what's going to happen when Funzi finally pops 6. And there's a jump in by Dendi. Cold Wall not going to hit. And Funzi just gets rid of the traps.
There's still the factor of the CK just free farming compared to Tiny, who ran in mid. Tiny hasn't killed a creep for 1.5 minutes. Now he's going to find a big stack of creeps, but still. He's falling behind from CK.
Mm-hmm.
And CK scales differently than Tiny. Much stronger in the mid game.
Well, looks like Funzi's in a little bit of trouble. He's still at level 6, so he's got no jump away, and he starts the pull on Arsat. Bucky Mag comes in. There goes your Ice Wall. The Black Hole going to catch out Dendi, and Arsat's not going to help him at all. And says, sorry, man, you're dead.
Yeah. The moment the Leshrac stun misses, I think they should try and back out. Of course, Dendi tried to save Leshrac by hitting Storm a little bit, but it's better to let Leshrac die for his mistake than to overstay with Lanaya.
And get TA, the hero, which, as you were saying, is meant to really start to control this game.
Mm.
You have that death to your name, you lose your extra gold. And that could have been, like, with the timing he's had, would have had in that middle lane. Could have been phase boots by now.
Yeah, pretty much. Oh. You should just try and let his teammates die first if anyone should die. But of course, it's hard to know that the entire enemy team is going to come in mid pretty much, aside from Tiny. Mm-hmm. But they are committing a lot of attention to Dandy's Lanaya right now.
We've got Bucky Mad rotating up top lane again, but no one's here. Windrunner's back at base, just chilling. While Lavors continues to free farm on that bottom lane, 58 for 14 now. Has managed to afford him 1,700 gold, Treads, Quilling Blade, and that's basically it for now. But Bucky Mad being getting pretty aggressive down here. So obviously with the tier 2 tower gone, he can do this, and we'll see Light of Heaven, but he'll never be able to pop anything off. He's just walking around searching for a kill, which he'll never get.
Yeah, he's walking around a little bit too much. The top lane is already secured. Farm for Tiny, his free farm.
Gotta get back inside that jungle, man. Every jungle needs a farmer. That's what it's all about.
He is going for a very early BKB, so he should try and just farm as much as possible right now, because his ulti is on cooldown. That's not when he should be looking for more ganks. But of course, he's angry Frenchman.
He's really not an angry Frenchman. Like, you know, Bucking Mad, don't you? You've met him. Yeah, actually, you would have met him at the last DreamHack.
Met him in Germany as well.
Oh, that's right. When you boys played up against the old MTW lineup. The one with Kebap, who is now switched to LoL.
Yes. You serious?
Let's move on.
Interesting. So Lanaya is up to her face boots now, pretty much, if she wants them. Let's see. Probably gonna buy them up. Oh, Power Treads. I like it more, especially against Tiny.
Yeah, Hellforce, you hate on that illusion. You hate on that illusion. Reality Rift and the Chaos Bolt to get the kill on it. But he bought drums. He bought his straight drums now.
Yeah.
And still having standard. 700 gold off his sleeve.
Standard.
That was something different from him. He's like, no.
No, I've done this before. A few times. CK.
Walks around with the E-Blade on Phantom Lancer. It's like, fine. Get an E-Blade up on Chaos Knight. It's magical damage, the Chaos Bolt.
Yeah, true.
That's a bad idea, by the way, people at home.
Don't do it.
Don't ever
Never
do
listen
that.
To Toby's advice when it comes to Dota. It's...
Hey, whoa. All right, that's...
It's fair enough.
It's... Semele. But Crit Profit works.
You're gonna gang Tiny now?
Yeah, it should be his death.
Oh,
if the troll trap can do. Look at Puppy, he's running up high. Tiny's already used his Avalanche and Toss. Shackled up, Reality Rifted, Latrak's done, and just wham.
Very dead is how we can summarize it. Mm-hmm. They should push top, I feel. Of course, they seem like they want to go mid now and go there, but it's probably easier top.
Well, they're probably wanting to prepare for Roshan. They've taken the tier 1, tier 2 on bot lane. They're hunting the jungle. They're looking for Mad.
No, they want to take tier 1 towers everywhere, but I don't feel they should go all to the same lane because they have Coddle in enemy team. Coddle is pretty good against this kind of push.
Unless Avorce does this. There's support coming in, and then again, there's also Chen Creeps making their move.
Friendly neighborhood toss.
Oh, power shot as well. Gave the extra damage that allowed Avorce to finish the job. And this will be tier 1 tower to go down. And I'm really waiting for them to jump in that Rosh pit very, very quickly.
Yeah, might be.
Either that or they push the tier 2 as well.
Would be good timing to go for it before Enigma has his BKB.
Oh, they're going to go tier 2. Edict to start. Fortification's already down, and that tower with 4 points and Edict and the rest... only 3 points. But the tower goes down very, very quickly. 13 minutes again. And we're looking at not all the tier 1, tier 2 towers out, but most of them.
Just securing a big advantage here in golds. And then they can make the obvious rotation top again. I'm surprised Na'Vi, they did this in last game too. They always like taking the mid tower before the top tower. It's weird to me because top is easier to push, in my opinion. But they did the same thing last game. But then it made sense because they had Broodmother, who was standing on top lane.
Yeah.
And Lanaya didn't go for face boots. He's probably saving for, you know, travels. Because he's buying BKB or Desolator, whatever he wants.
Would you still get the BTs though?
BTs are good. If you don't upgrade your boots for a long period of time, as he is doing now, then going for BTs makes more sense.
Well, there's the BKB now up for Enigma. So 14-minute BKB bought straight for him.
Yeah.
And also a smoke on the courier. So they want to see if they can make something out of this. Have they we got any to. Wards? We've got a TA trap. We got a TA trap right here. If they get close enough to this when they smoke, then it's going to reveal off the fact of what they've got.
Yeah. We have drums finished on the Shrek.
And then also the TA illusion comes in.
Just being annoying.
Mm-hmm. Another one going the way of Tiny.
Just realized Tiny has no mana at all, but they have Chakra, level 2. Pretty weak, but
there should be enough for him to get a full combo out.
Yeah.
And maybe have an extra avalanche up his sleeve later on.
Yeah, 240 all you need, so you'll get more mana soon.
There's your obvious rotation top lane. Na'Vi's moving the whole kit and caboodle up there. And Sox trying to clear it off. Now he's out of mana. Someone chakra that man. There we go. Up to 200. So it's still not a full combo.
Magic stick is going to get him up enough.
With 1 point.
Yeah.
Nope, just short. Now he has enough. He was short by 4 mana.
Yeah.
And look, Vorse just hiding in the tree. Like they've cut themselves their own path up. There's the avalanche already getting on a Vorse. He gets a 3 second stun out in
they're
the Tiny.
Burst.
So they can't get the proper combo. Yeah. Then the black hole hits on absolutely nothing. Maybe it does when a Vorse finally hits the deck. Thought we had ourselves a PGG, but it was only faking it. And then Ryze up into the jungle.
Ryze.
He's on the run. Nice TP back out again. But Ryze just going completely bush. And does go down. Puppy brings him down.
Yeah. Oh, he needed to land his black hole on CK. And it missed. He only caught 2 creeps. The Ursa and the Wildkin.
Was it the toss of Tiny that threw the CK back in again?
No, I think he walked into it.
Black hole! Black hole! I gotta see it!
Yeah, he's like, hey, they say that you can't see a black hole, so let's try walking closer.
There's supposed to be gold in the middle of the black hole, didn't you know? Didn't you know?
Exactly. What if a rainbow ends in a black hole?
I don't know, man.
I don't know.
Is it possible?
Does that break the system?
I think the rainbow just bounces around the accretion disk.
Bouncing rainbows.
Bing. Shackle flying from Light of Heaven. Looks like a hit on absolutely nothing. Just having a fish.
Yeah.
Fishing with shackles. It's now bad. I've now just saw the best custom map ever created called Fishing for Shackles. All right, now Storm Spirit going to jump in, going to pick up Puppy. 4 second stun comes out, but the Ice Path is going to make sure Puppy remains there. Nothing he could do about it in the end, and he'll probably lose his entire creep
Storm
army as well.
Storm is dangerous, catches your heroes easily like this. But the best custom map ever is Go Fish. Takes about 1 or 2 hours. It's based on you fishing. You can play it in Warcraft 3. Very nice. And he is going for Desolator on Lanaya. He's running in with his Haste Rune towards mid. I think they want to fight this. CK is going to go in first, if anything.
Don't see why not. Except he hasn't picked up the Desolator just yet, and Storm's already running back out of here.
Yeah.
Well, now the Deso will fly in. Or not. No, yes.
No, not
yes.
At all.
No, oh, yes, yeah. Yes. Flies past him, goes back. Flies past him, goes back. And now they can also go Roshan, which is what I've been waiting
definitely.
For.
Very quickly as well, because they see someone on top lane. Coddle was there. They know that it's warded, it seems. So
one die war, but TA starts setting up traps.
They still kill it so quickly that they could just force the issue. They know that it's cooldown on Black Hole still for a while longer.
And such good wards from Arsar. It's not even the fact that, like, Shiba Gaming knows that they're doing Roshan. They've got so much notification. One ward in the middle lane, and he even ran up to the creep wave just and very, quite visibly displayed it to Shiba Gaming, basically saying, you know what? If you want it, then you can come and get it. But you got to know that we know exactly where you're moving.
Yeah. And they get dewarded on bottom lane. But they're so strong at this point. Dendi looking for kills, but not going to kill Storm.
He could do a decent chunk of damage, though, but yeah, not enough to get a kill.
Takes 4 hits.
And blink. Bucky Man is also going to TP out of there.
It would actually be quicker to just walk there, I think.
Man, is Zan Ward in the perfect position out of range of both the tower and the D ward?
It could be just a little bit up further, even. But yeah, it's very nice.
So still gives him the vision. The sentry ward does absolutely nothing apart from reveal a little bit on, like, if they come out.
Exactly.
Well, maybe trouble in the middle lane. Denny jumps in, Meld hit, but not enough to follow through with. Thought the trolls from Puppy might have been looking for an ensnare.
So it is going to be power treads anyway on Dendy, just buying them late.
Want to finish up the Deso beforehand.
Yeah. Not a lot of farm coming in top. Someone is going to go there. Dendy has no TP. Looks like Windrunner is going to take it.
More farm for Light of Heaven. He loves farm.
What happened to First Blood this game? Who died?
First Blood was all. It was Chen. Chen picked it up. Navi picked it up. It was Chen who took it, and it should have been Dendy dying.
So Strake is. Oh, the streak is broken.
Correct.
Damn you, Navi. I like Leshrac's item in his stash.
By the way, for guys tuning in, some guys are helping you out in the chat, and they're 100% correct. If you do have issues where there's no sound, sometimes Dailymotion will bug in Chrome, so you'll need to switch to either Firefox or Internet Explorer in order to watch the live stream. This is a Dailymotion thing.
But if they have no sound, they can't hear you say that.
Oh my lord, I cannot deny your logic. Once I fucking mag goes down as well while I'm just facepalming myself. 3 seconds stun out on Funzy. Latrak follow up stun and so disintegrated. Puppy's nuke level 4 hit that as two. That as well. Man, my English language is just being completely broken in grammar. My bottom lane looks a defender forced. He has a blink dagger. Just jumping into the midst of it all. Arsart getting himself nailed up a little bit while Dendy hunting Tiny again. Kaklus also in the neighborhood. We've got so much initiation from Na'Vi now. And the range initiation from Avorce when you combine that blink dagger with Reality Rift.
Yeah.
Instantly catches the hero out. And Chen,
He got sent home.
Yeah, Chen sent him back. And Dendy trying to hide.
Dendy's in trouble now.
He's dead. I guess the Immortal lost.
With a remnant there, he shouldn't be able to blink.
Nope.
It's impossible, I think.
Couldn't even get refraction off.
Some damage sources are impossible to blink away from, even no matter how quick you are. I think remnant is one of those things.
I think, well, it instantly triggers when someone's in the neighborhood. It's like a proximity mine with no timer.
Exactly.
Yeah, you remember
Ice Path is obviously pretty annoying if you.
Yeah, because you're
ice path.
It's the same instant stun kind of thing.
Yeah.
You ever play like GoldenEye? Like you walk past one of those proximity mines and all of a sudden it triggers off and you've got like half a second to walk away.
No, I never did. Never played that, sadly.
How could you say to... I'm not talking about the Wii version, peoples. I'm not talking about the Wii. I'm talking about Nintendo 64 GoldenEye.
Yeah, I think my friend had it. And I might have played it one or two times there and enjoyed it, but then I didn't have it, so. That's why I played Rock and Roll Racing. Stuff like that. Imba games.
That's why I played Robot Unicorn. Wait, no, it wasn't out back then.
Yeah.
I played Robot Unicorn before it was even released. I went to the world of Tron and pulled it out. Anyway, meanwhile, back at the world of Dota. I don't know if you also noticed too that this game has kind of reminded me a lot of not of the first game, but the goal graph definitely is leaning along the same patterns as that first game. It's just the shoe is definitely on the other foot right now.
Yeah.
When Na'Vi, they just control everything. All the towers are down. The only difference is Shiba Gaming have managed to take a tower before the 30-minute mark. And in fact, they've taken two, and that was something which Na'Vi were in like. Unable to achieve.
Yeah, it's gonna be hard now because they Shiba, that is, they rely on Na'Vi's mistakes now. And Navi are doing exactly what I was saying that Shiba should do in the first game, just taking it more easy, farming up. Of course, Dendi is farming it up close to enemy base because he doesn't care. But
I think all he wanted to do was snipe off that bottom tower, but then they realized he's going to do that and they got rid of it.
Mm.
Deny it themselves.
Yeah, well, with the tower gone, it's pretty easy to push through, so they're going to try. They have Invis rune, but there's a lot of sentry wards, and I hope he understands this, Arsard.
Connell brings friends back. It's Tani returning to defend this bottom.
Arsard.
How far is he going? Ice Path was prepped then. Ice Path was prepped.
Yeah, but wrecks are falling.
Yeah, it's just the Edict sitting on the side. There's no creep wave to stop it. And Fortification, nice black hole. Avors and Dendi both caught in that one. Hand of God, not enough to keep him alive as well as the mech. But Avors jumps up, almost able to bring down Sox. Maybe enough when he has that Chaos Ball back. 3 seconds on the stun. Right click. Caught it with a blast. Bucking mad. Toss up in the air. Riyadra pulling back in again. So Avors can finish the job. The bottom ranks will go down. Avors will be the sacrificial lamb. He can't get past his tier 3 tower without dying. Maybe movie blinks and disjoint set. I apologize for doubting you, Avors. Storm Spirit jumping down, looking for Light of Heaven now. When Puppy turns around, Nuke, Shackle, won't lash, Mini Stun, Power Shot. Quick jump by Funzy, not going to be enough. Now the Edict damage, pulsing actually, through Bucking Mad, four starving him up so he can continue to do that damage. Ryze, smack bang in the middle of the engagement. And we'll give a little bit of mana back to. Ooh, hello, that's a very aggressive TP. It's so Funzy can get a little bit closer. Maybe look for a pull jump if he can get it. There's the jump down, goes for Puppy, Line of Heaven. Says line him up, can't shackle him up however. Nice little jump, avoids the power shot. That would have been his death if it hit right now. And Coddle also giving a covering blast. And Calculus just stunning the air. But 12 to 5 now.
That's Calculus. He's so stunning.
He hates oxygen.
Yeah. Illusion. That's why he, you know, sets fire to it. But Tiny is getting a little bit stronger. I mean, he almost has his Aghanims. This is what they have going for them. They lost their racks, fine, but they can kill Mega Creeps pretty easily if they get a strong Tiny. The bad thing is, though, that CK and Lanaya are both equally strong as Tiny. So.
Well, if not stronger, really.
Yeah, CK is probably stronger, for sure.
I'd say the Blink Dagger on CK doesn't make him as strong as he possibly could be. It was more of an opening
it's
kind of item.
It's working nicely in this game.
Mm. But as far as like if you had a raw man-to-man kind of fight between Tiny as well as CK,
yeah,
the fight would definitely be lost by Chaos Knight if Tiny has Aghanims.
I don't think so right now because of the levels. Tiny is only level 13. He's not super strong. I think that CK would kill him actually.
We should just ask them. Man up.
Yeah.
One v one.
Guys, can you just meet in the middle? Meet at the old Roshan's.
Mm-hmm. Bucky mad. It's a good thing they got themselves a ward up in that high ground. They're just checking out and see Havors running into their own jungle.
It's gonna be a pub one day.
Gee, old Roshan's.
It's gonna be awesome.
We'll keep asking for the custom maps and to create them until Valve says okay, we'll give you the ability for custom maps, just because you asked for it, just because you asked for it. Café Rochling?
Please stop.
That's like be professional, man. Be professional. Velad is professional caster, and you must be a professional caster. Nope. It looks like a Vorst now. This looks like more like a real Vorst. Heart now coming up next. And this will make him unkillable. Even with the Aghanim's tree, there's just no proper, like, huge damage. It's not going to come out from the Storm Spirit. Fonzie doesn't really have that much
comes
bounce.
Comes to the combo initiation. Here
nice
goes
jump.
Storm.
And then decides not to keep jumping. Or does jump, but in a different direction.
Oh, he didn't have Tiny. Tiny already turned around.
Mm. But Tiny has tree. But he doesn't have Aegis. Denny's about to pick that one up. Damn, that's an easy Roshan.
Yeah, all the time. And this is the weird thing that CK is already up here. CK is chasing Jakiro, who is running for his life.
And then he sees the TP coming in. He can go straight on Storm if he wanted to.
Yeah, but Storm is annoying to initiate on still.
Yeah. Quick jump, avoid the bolt or the rift.
Yeah, CK stun is not as instant as you want it to be.
Well, looks like a little bit of trouble for Denny. He's on really low life. Avalanche toss has already been used, and now Storm's going to jump in. Denny just trying to keep his position on the side of the fight. Then he can go in for Tani. Black Hole will trigger. Enigma, everybody just walked into it at the end of the day. But hand of God, Denny was the only one not involved in that, and now we're going to sell it a double kill for Revorce. Reality Rip will fail. Fails again. Now maybe we're just with a pulse damage. Bucking Mad will go down. And Rise on the run from Dendy, soloing him, dropping the gem back at the base. The courier snipes and brings it back to safety. But this is going to be mid racks after bottom racks, and should be a Dignitas versus Na'Vi grand final for ESWC 2012.
Most likely, yeah. There's no way for him to recover, and there Jakiro dies again. GG call is pretty
it's imminent. Yeah, it's close. Imminent.
Yeah.
And Dendy just getting all the cash he can from killing off all these wonderful Moonwells.
Yeah, that was so Revorce though. Did you see the black hole? He's like, oh, there's a black hole, let's run into it. He's done that several times this game, just running into a black hole.
Yeah.
Just charge. Don't even care.
Maybe he's just like, hey, just make it an entertaining sport. Revorce, there's that blinking 4 seconds on Storm Spirit. Dendy, dead, but Aegis. Havorst is already dead, however. But we are fighting up against Mega Creeps. There's that right click and Calculus just disintegrates to Dendy. And then to Funzi. Almost 2 hits to bring him down. He went down to 80 HP, and the power shot from Light of Heaven was almost on target for it as well. And Dendy has blink off cooldown. I think he's currently waiting for, there's the blink and death.
Ow.
Triple kill from Dendy. And there's buyback, so if he wants Rampage, he can get it. He'll go back in. Check out for Funzi. 2 clicks is all it will take. 2 clicks. Count them. Count them as they come. Count them as they come. There's Ryze. 1 right click. There we go. Ultra kill for him. Blink down. Find someone. Bucking Mad. 3 clicks is going to take it. Light of Heaven steals it. He is not giving him the Rampage at all. Another right click. 1 right click is all Denny needs. He cannot get it. Even the stun and the ulti. Reality Rip calls back in, and Havorst will take this one. His teammates hate him. His teammates hate him. And he'll dive in for it. There's Wicked Sick, but it's too late. He doesn't get the full glory for it all. Then it will be the glory of Na'Vi going to the grand final. Which means we'll have one last game for today. It'll be Team Shakira. It will be knocked down to the third place decider where they will go up against their French comrades. To find out who is the third best team at ESWC 2012. So it'll be Imaginary Gaming going up against Sheba Gaming. That'll be coming up next, so if you want to stick around for that match, please definitely do so. We will not be going anywhere. We'll see you guys soon.